दिस इज इंग्लिश शॉर्ट हैंड डिक्टेशन नंबर 128 एंड द डिक्टेशन स्पीड इज 160 वर्ड्स पर मिनट. रेडी स्टार्ट. मैडम दिस इज ए वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. द प्राइस राइज इन वेजिटेबल्स एंड फ्रूट्स हैज बीन वेरी सब्सटेंशियल इन द रिसेंट पास्ट विच हैज क्रिएटेड टेंशन नॉट ओनली इन द कंट्री बट ऑल्सो इन द हाउस. The basic reason is that most of them are perishable. I have been raising my voice in the house for quite a long time. The importance of this is because they are being produced in the rural areas by the farming community and are being consumed by the lower middle class and the poor sections of society. It is because it does not affect the life of the rich or the upper middle class, where the share of essential commodities is very meager. So here the ban or duty-free import is not the solution. We have to encourage the production in this country because farmers are very competent to produce the requirement of the total country. He has given a statement here itself that the price which was rupees 4000 per quintal has come down to rupees 200 per quintal in 40 days. It means that the pathetic condition of the farmer who is producing by spending all his life is crippled. So we have to take care of consumers as well as farmers who are in large numbers in this country. They are 70% of the population. So I wish to know from the Honorable Minister whether he will think in terms of providing a price stabilization fund. When there is an opportunity to the farmer to sell his produce outside the country at a very substantial price of rupees 4000, he should not be disturbed. He can provide a price stabilization fund in this regard and also bring in new technology, storage facilities, and encourage people to start storage by giving loans at the rate of interest of 3%. He should also give power subsidy. I wish to know from the Honorable Minister whether he will think in terms of providing these facilities and save the farmer as well as the consumer by providing cheap loan, storage facility, and price stabilization fund. Madam, today India is becoming an emerging economy. The world predicts that in the next decade, India will emerge as an economic power. I remember the days in 1947, probably in the early days of our independence, when India went with a begging bowl before the world for cereals and pulses. There was an uncertainty, and the whole world could not feed or meet the demands of India. The successive prime ministers, the great men of vision, have assured in policies, and after the Green Revolution, India today is a country which is producing the maximum wheat in the world. India is a country which is producing the maximum rice in the world. India is a country which is producing the maximum milk in the world. Today, even if the whole world declares moratorium against India, the people of India will not die of hunger. This guarantee has come to the country through the successive policies of governments in the past. Today, when we are facing an unprecedented crisis, we have to see what are the steps taken by the government in the last year and in the year to come to face the problems which this country is facing. Before I deal with the other major points, I would like to share the sentiments and support the views expressed by the Honorable President. It was not only a demand from the opposition, but some of the members of the ruling party also went to the Prime Minister and told him that a joint parliamentary committee to look into this whole issue was a legitimate demand. Our Prime Minister assured us that they were not against any form of inquiry. They have nothing to hide, but at the same time, if this House cannot discuss an issue which is before the nation, then we will be failing in our duty. They wanted this House to debate and discuss this issue. Today, the wise counsel is prevailing on everybody. We all have agreed to have a discussion on this issue. Whatever be the decision, every party has a right to take its own decision. But discussion could not take place and the whole session was aborted. The people who who elected us, who expected that we would be discussing many vital issues affecting the country, were all disappointed. At least past is past, and today we have decided to have a discussion on this matter. In the words of the leaders who spoke this morning, I hope this will be a productive session, making up the loss which we have suffered in the past. We also had some sad moments. The Honorable President has commented on some such tragedies which had happened, like the severe cloud burst which affected the people of Ladakh. Be it a cloud burst in Ladakh or the natural calamity, it depends on how the government of the day is coming up to ameliorate the sufferings of the people, what steps the government is taking to redress the grievances of the people. The Honorable President has complimented the UPA government for the effective steps it has taken when this natural calamity had overtaken the people of Ladakh. In such situations, it is the preparedness of the UPA government, decisive action of the UPA government to help the people, which is being complimented by the Honorable President. In the last session of Parliament, we met just before the beginning of the Commonwealth Games. There was a hue and cry by the members that there was no sufficient preparedness on the part of the organizing committee and there were a lot of irregularities involved in it. Nobody in this house was happy about the situation prevailing at that point of time. What has this government done? This government has conducted an inquiry. The chairman of the organizing committee was a senior member of our party. The charge against the chairman of the organizing committee was not proved, but our party leadership decided that he should step down from the position he was holding in the party. Has this happened anywhere before? Can anybody quote an example like this? A senior member of our party was asked to resign from the post of secretary of the Congress Parliamentary Party. An inquiry is going on and nobody is going to be spared. This government is meeting this situation with a resolute courage and that goes to the credit of this government. There is another positive aspect. During the Commonwealth Games, our sportspersons brought laurels to the country. I remember many international festivals and Commonwealth Games held in the past. Our team always came back as tragic heroes. Even small countries got more medals than India did, and we were always a poor spectator. But unprecedented medal tally in the Commonwealth Games 2010 has made this country proud. Let us compliment the sportspersons of our country. There may be some lapses in the organizing part of it, and that is being inquired into by the government. But at the same time, these Commonwealth Games in Delhi were a success. The people of Delhi have cooperated with the games. Our sportspersons have fared well in these games and they made our country proud. It is definitely a matter which we can feel proud of. Madam, we have passed through a very difficult year in our country. Inflation had been a problem in the past year. Certain parts of the country have suffered unacceptably high levels of violence, especially the left-wing extremism in certain states and also extremist activities in Kashmir Valley. How the government faced and is facing these problems is a matter which is being narrated by the Honorable President. I would like to make it very clear that the 5 points which were mentioned in the President's address form the cornerstone of this declaration. These 5 major points of her speech which the government is going to implement are also a report card of the last year and also a plan of action for the next year. What the government did on all these 5 points is the moot point we have been discussing today. The first and foremost thing was to combat inflation in particular, to protect the common man from the effects of rising food prices. In the last session, even though we could not discuss important matters, the hue and cry in this august house was about the price of onion. It was hitting the ceiling. It was rupees 80 per kilo. All pulses, cereals, edible oils and everything was beyond the reach of common men, and that was an alarming situation. But what is it today? The Honorable President has said that combating inflation is our first priority. Have we done justice to this statement? Have we taken enough steps to implement this program? The food price inflation had gone up to a level of 20%, which was unprecedented. What steps has this government taken? I still remember there was an allegation that the policy of the government government is failing. Let us see what steps the government has taken. The import regime has been liberalized to ease constraints on critical items. Export of commodities like edible oils and pulses has been banned. Pulses are being supplied at subsidized rates through public distribution system. Public sector units have been directed to open more retail outlets for selling vegetables. These are some of the steps taken by the government. The food price inflation, which was 20% when we were meeting here in the last session of parliament, has come down to 8%.